Welcome to Kasm Workspaces. In this tutorial, we will replace the self-signed certificates on a Kasm Workspace with our own custom SSL certificates. To do this, we will first need to determine the type of architecture we have for our Kasm Workspace. We will need to know whether we have a single server installation or a multi-server one. Regardless of whether you have a single or multi-server, you will need to replace the SSL certificate for the web app role on all your web apps. If you use a front load balancer or a reverse proxy, your HTTPS would be terminated at the load balancer or proxy, not the web app. In that case, we will need to change the SSL certificate on the load balancer or proxy instead of the web app, as we will demonstrate in this video. If you do not use a load balancer or reverse proxy, you need to change the SSL certificate on all the web apps because any of the web apps could potentially resolve the HTTPS. For information, see our video and documentation below. Now that we know which architecture we are going to use, we know where to change the SSL certificate. In this instance, we will change our SSL certificate on the web app. I'll be using a multi-server architecture for this demonstration. In a single server architecture, we would stop the Kasm services and replace the existing Kasm Nginx cert file and Kasm Nginx key file with a public and private key that we generated from Let's Encrypt on a single server. On a multi-server architecture, you would repeat the same steps once per each web app role. After you have changed the certificates, you would restart the Kasm services, close and reopen your web browser, and then navigate to your Kasm Workspaces webpage. If you needed to replace your certs on a load balancer, you would navigate to your load balancer's configuration screen. For example, if you use AWS, you will navigate to your web apps, then come down to load balancers. In your load balancers, you would navigate to the correct load balancer, and in that correct load balancer, you would have a listener. Click on your listener, navigate to that listener certificates, then select the correct certificate for that load balancer. If the correct certificate does not exist, you would use whatever methods are necessary for your current cloud provider to create that certificate. Alternatively, you could use the procedures we're about to demonstrate to generate a Let's Encrypt certificate and upload or import that Let's Encrypt certificate by clicking Add Certificate, choosing Import Certificates, and providing the private key, public key, and the certificate authority keychain. We will now create an SSL certificate for our instance. On my right-hand side, I have the same web apps as well as an extra terminal to my machine. I have already installed Certbot. Certbot is a utility commonly used with the Let's Encrypt service to generate certificates easily. I have gone ahead and copied over a commonly used script for Certbot. For this Certbot, I will generate a cert only using the manual method. I will use the command line switch to agree to their terms of service. I will identify myself as an authority for this domain by using the DNS method. I will also optionally provide my company's email address so that I can receive updates for this certificate. The TACD option is where I specify my domain. If I needed to create a certificate for more than one domain, I would copy this multiple times. In the example below, I have my parent subdomain, and then I have a wildcard for that parent subdomain. This is necessary if we are using the direct-to-agent architecture model in Kasm Workspaces. Normally, Kasm web apps will proxy all user interactions between end users and the agent servers. Their workspaces are proxied through the web app, and then from the web app, they connect to the agent. This allows us to expose only one port and one IP address to our Kasm Workspaces. However, in the direct-to-agent Kasm configuration, your end users will directly reach your agent via a publicly accessible IP address. When using a direct-to-agent architecture, both the web apps and agents are accessible via the domain name of your Kasm workspace. There are certain scenarios, such as when operating agents in multiple regions, where this signal flow is desirable. In those scenarios, we want to have a wildcard in the sands of your SSL certificate so that when Kasm creates our agents for us using autoscaling, each one of those agents would be secured as a child subdomain of the parent domain. In our example, we are going to take the lines from sudo all the way to tacd. We are going to copy and paste it and modify it. We will then change this to our example email address, support@kasmweb.com, and then we will need to change this domain name to the actual domain name of our Kasm Workspaces instance. Now you should be prompted to deploy a DNS text record under a specific name. We will need to copy the text record name given and continue to your cloud provider to add a new record. Here we have pasted over the name in the record name section. You will also need to copy the provided value from your terminal to the value section under the cloud provider. The last thing we need to do is to change the record type to TXT. You should now see the Acme challenge for your VDI. We will go back to our terminal and press enter now that the DNS record has been added. This will create a new certificate. Now, in the terminal, after your certificate is created, you will be given the location of your certificate and your key. In order to copy these credentials, you will need to use the cat command with the given directory. Now we're going to import the SSL certificate to your load balancer. Navigate to the cloud provider's load balancer certificate configuration screen. Choose the option to import a certificate. First, we will provide a private key in the private key section. Next, we will provide a certificate body, which is the top part of the full chain certificate file generated by Certbot. For the certificate authority chain, we'll get the remaining parts from the full chain certificate file. Finally, we will click the import button, then click add pending certificate. In this example, we used an AWS load balancer where we added a custom SSL certificate. Some cloud providers, such as AWS, allow you to create a cloud-managed SSL certificate. If we had chosen to use an AWS-generated SSL certificate with our load balancer, we would not have needed to use Certbot to generate a cert. We would also not have needed to import the certificate because it would be created and managed within your cloud provider's platform. Before we proceed farther, please check if there are any other active certificates joined to this load balancer's listener. If so, remove any certificates that are no longer needed. You can see that I've already removed all the other certificates that I don't want to associate with this listener. So, at this point, we can now go back and navigate to our URL for this instance of Kasm Workspace, and it is secure. In this video, I will be showing you how to add a custom SSL certificate without a load balancer. First, I will SSH into Webapp 1. Then, on Webapp 1, I will stop the Kasm services. I will stop the Kasm services on Webapp 2 and any other Webapp that I have also. The next thing I'm going to do is to navigate to the appropriate directory. We can see here that the appropriate directory for SSL certs in Kasm is the /op/kasm/current/certs directory. So for the next thing I want to do is I want to create a backup of the Kasm cert. This is not strictly necessary, but it's just a good practice. So I'm going to say copy Kasm nginx cert. I'll create a cert backup with the similar name, and I'll do the same thing here for the private key. Now that I have a backup, I'm going to clear the contents of this public cert. Now that the public cert is empty, I will edit it. We are currently on the copy and replace section in our documentation, and instead of using the copy command, I will use a vi editor to get the same job done. The command I will use is vi kasm_nginx.crt. I will then find my proper cert in my notepad, paste it, and save the file. I will repeat these steps for the other web apps. Then I will edit the private key in the web app 1 and restart my Kasm services. Again, I will repeat these steps for the other web apps. Next, I will navigate to our URL and test to make sure everything is working. Sometimes you need to close this tab or even close the web browser or open a new tab to see the change. You have now completed your SSL certificate updates. Thank you so much for watching this video of Kasm Workspaces. If you have any questions, feel free to visit our documentation down below.